The first book I wanted to talk to y'all about, I don't know if you can see it, is The Universe versus Alex Woods. This is a really cool story. If you are a fan of those movies where it starts at the end of the story and then it goes back and takes you through it, that's how this story is set up right here. And it's about basically how the universe has been against Alex Woods since birth. He was hit by a meteor and he ends up having epilepsy. And that's when you have seizures, something in your brain. Anyway, so he has epilepsy. He ends up getting bullied from it. And he meets this man named Mr. Peterson. He's an elderly gentleman. And he's running away from bullies at one point and trespasses on his lawn to try and get away from him. And that's how their friendship starts. And it goes through from when he's around 10 or 11 all the way up until when he's 17. And that's where the story starts. When he's 17 and he's in England trying to get back into England, and he's stopped by the police and he's like, how did I get into this predicament? And he's got ashes, like a urn of ashes next to him, along with some paraphernalia. And he's like, how did I get here? And it tells the whole story about that. So it's a really good book about, you know, just friendship and coming of age and everything like that. The next book you about is Relish, My Life in the Kitchen by Lucy Nicely. And this is part autobiographical, part instructional. The autobiographical part is about her life being raised by a professional caterer and chef, and all her experiences in the kitchen and through life. And she gets taken on these amazing journeys to like Japan, I think, and Mexico and Europe. And it's amazing the travel she's been on that I was not able to when she was doing these. And the instructional part of it is she, in between the chapters, puts in little recipes that you can try that's from her family or stuff that she picked up along the way, like from Julia Child. And I tried one of them. They were really tasty. So this is a graphic novel. Really fun to read. I couldn't put it down. And the last book is The Night's War. This is a big book. And this is actually, I believe y'all were around when Hurricane Katrina hit. Yeah, this is a story. It's a fictional piece, but it has the factual part of Katrina set into it. And Lanisha is the character in the story. And she's around 12. And she has like some magical qualities about her where she can see ghosts, and her mother died at birth, and she has a guardian who can see the future. And so a lot of people try and stay away from her because they're kind of scared about those aspects of her life, but she ends up having, you know, friends, and it's set day by day, so you can see the newscasters and get the anticipation that the hurricane's coming. And it's about her story of survival and to perseverance, because she doesn't let all of the troubles with school or, you know, not having friends and the hurricane, it doesn't let her get her down. She makes it head on, and she takes care of her guardian, Mama Yaga, and they're able, you know, to weather the storm, basically. But I can't give you all the spoilers. You'll have to read it. So I hope you enjoy this, and I hope you check these books out because they're really good books. So thank you.